This shoe's so fire, bro. Hey, yo, what's good, I'm Mob? Welcome back to Arsenal News, where we upload a video every single Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday. Before I start, I do want to make one announcement, and that is to not forget to sign up for the Yeezy Mask giveaway. All you gotta do is go down in the description, click on the link below, and follow all the instructions. And for everything that you do, you get one entry, and for every single entry, you do raise your chances. And the winner gets chosen at the end of the month, and that winner gets to choose one out of the three Yeezy Masks that are listed in the giveaway. Today, we do got some talking to do about this new sneaker that came out. Well, it hasn't come out yet, but it has been announced by Yeezy Mafia, and it is announced that Adidas will be dropping this shoe in December, and the shoe that I'm talking about is this new Adidas silhouette. It is an Adidas EQT ADV mid. However, this is not something like you've seen before. It is a completely brand new shoe, and in my opinion, the shoe is absolute fire. It's absolute fuego, and I just cannot get over the fact that they are dropping this sneaker. Unfortunately, when I look at the shoe, I see that the white part is not Boost, but then if you look at the Yeezy 700, that doesn't have Boost either, but it does have Boost when it's on the inside. What I'm trying to say is that the sneaker could have Boost, but most likely this one doesn't, because it is an Adidas EQT, and the last Adidas EQT that had Boost, you can actually see it all around the shoe, and it was the most comfortable shoe I've ever put on my feet. But anyways, let's talk a little bit about the shoe. This shoe is rumored to release in December, and it is a part of the Adidas and Dragon Ball Z collab. It is the seventh sneaker out of the seven, obviously. I mean, you guys didn't know there was seven, but it is a seven out of the seven. There is six other ones. The first one is the ZX500RM, which is Goku. Then you have Young One, which is Frieza. Then you have the Debrupt, which looks like a human race, and it is Son Gohan. Then you have a Profear, which is Cell, and you have Ultra Tech, which is Vegeta, and then you have Commando, which is Majin Buu. I don't know how to say it. I think it's Majin Buu. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's what it is. I really don't watch too much Dragon Ball Z myself, so I really don't know. But if I'm wrong, like I said, correct me down in the comments below. And of course, the last one is a EQT mid ADV, and this one does represent, or it is supposed to take the colors, and the silhouette is supposed to come out of Shenlong, which people don't know what it is. But according to the picture right here, it is a dragon in the show, but I thought it was Shenron, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people were confused about that. I don't know. I really don't know too much about Dragon Ball Z. I'm not a big fan on that. I'm just going based off of what I know and my knowledge. So the Goku and Frieza sneakers are supposed to drop in August. The Son Gohan and Cell are supposed to drop in September. The Vegeta and Majin Buu are supposed to drop in November. And of course, the Shenlong is supposed to drop in December, which is the one we're going to talk about mostly in this video. And now moving on to the shoe, it looks like it's a prime knit upper, which I'm so happy about because I love prime knit. Prime knit is so comfortable. I'm actually wearing a pair myself right now. I'm wearing the OG NMDs. I don't know if you guys can see that. And then you do have your green laces held on by those darker green plastic tabs. And then you do have the red right below that, which is supposed to be the color of like the lining of the dragon. And then you do have the white midsole with the three stripes again. And unfortunately, that white midsole does not have any Boost, which I'm so bummed out about, which I really wish it had because I absolutely love Boost and makes the shoe that much better. That being said, the shoe most likely will be around probably like 150, maybe 170 because it's a collab. And if it was with Boost, probably be like around 200. That's just what I'm guessing. Don't take my word for it, but that's just what my guesses are. And then going down to the outsole, you do have a green outsole to match the green prime knit upper. And then if you look at the middle of the shoe, there is an E showing, and right there I'm pretty sure it says EQT. Then around the sock liner, it is a darker green, and then below that you do have yellow stripes, which I think it's supposed to represent the dragon's stomach. And then those three stripes, well, not three stripes, just like a bunch of red lines, and like there's split down the middle, three down. I don't know what that's supposed to represent. I can't even look at the picture and tell you guys. If you guys know, let me know. I think it's like some Dragon Ball Z sign. Like I said, I'm not a big fan of Dragon Ball Z, but if you guys know, let me know. And then you do have the red heel tab, which I think is meant to represent the dragon again with the red line. It's just meant to match. I'm gonna go ahead and say it just matches the tongue or the eyes because those are red as well. The next sneaker that I think is super fuego in this collab is the Goku one, which is the ZX500RM, which is a completely new silhouette. It reminds me of the Nike Boost without the Boost though. You basically have a Nike upper, and then you have a completely different sole. It looks like a really old vintage sole, which I'm guessing they're gonna bring back, especially to this shoe. That's what it looks like. And I love how from the toe to the heel, you do have that like really white yellowish color fading into that darker orange, which is supposed to represent Goku and his outfit. And that sneaker drops in August, and I'm gonna guess the price is going to be around like 130 and 150, somewhere around there. It shouldn't be any higher than that, especially if it does not have any Boost. Anyways, guys, that's pretty much the end of the video. And I know that before I go, I always give a shout out to the fan of the day. And today's fan of the day does go to Fanuali Tay. Whoa, shoot. Damn, another hard last name, yo. I swear I always get stuck with these. Let me try one more time. Today's fan of the day goes to Fanuali Segaye. I don't even know. I tried, yo. I tried. It's spelled T-S-E-G-A-Y-E. Anyways, guys, if you guys did enjoy, make sure to give a video a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe. We are trying to get to 25,000 subscribers by the end of this month. Make sure you keep grinding. It's your boy, Sneaky, signing out.